Well, hello, my friends. This is Michael Vincent. Welcome to another book review. Before I begin, I'd like to take this moment to thank all of you for your kind comments on the very first video book review that I shared on the 1st of January. That book featured the wonderful work of the great magician Helda Gamirez. I was so encouraged by your feedback. I thought I want to get this video ready in time for February 1st. So here I am recording this video for you now, which I hope you will enjoy. I've got a long list of books that I'm excited to talk about, and today's selection is a classic. It's the beautiful book, and the gentleman who wrote it is someone I've had the utmost admiration for the last few years, in fact, ever since I first came onto Facebook. I think that's where I first saw him sharing some of the videos. And let me tell you about this gentleman before I mention his name. Is it possible to like someone before you meet them? I believe so, because there was something about this gentleman that resonated with me. I sensed a generous spirit. I've sensed a kind heart, dedicated, passionate, and warm. There was a warmth in his humanity that I felt, and I thought, wow, not only that, he's a great magician as well. And before I bought this book that I'll be talking about, I had the opportunity to meet him. I met him in his hometown of Buenos Aires. I made a trip to Argentina in 2018, and everything I felt about this gentleman came true. It was already there. He greeted me warmly in his home. We had a wonderful time talking magic. In fact, we spent a fantastic Friday evening with a group of other Argentinian magicians, and we were all discussing magic and so forth, and it was really excellent. And I asked him about his publications, because most of his work was published in Spanish. And it just so happened that Vanishing Ink had one of his books translated, and I'm really excited and delighted to share with you the incredible book by Roberto Mansilla, and his book is called Naypes. I hope I pronounced it well, because I'm learning Spanish at the moment and I'm practicing Naypes. In fact, I was communicating with Roberto a few days ago and I asked him, what does this mean? And he said, this is a very old style of Spanish, and Naypes translated literally means cards, as in playing cards. So Naypes. So what is it about this book that merits me talking about it on this video for your consideration? Well, it took me completely by surprise, because before purchasing this book, I had previously purchased a book by Roberto Giobbi on stand-up card magic. And Giobbi's book is a complete infrastructure on presenting card magic for a large audience, not close up. This book also features material for that specific context, stand-up card magic, for the parlor environment. And what makes this book really interesting for me as a study, one, I was very impressed with Roberto's research. He completely understands the time frame when this particular style of magic was in vogue, 1800s, well into the early 1900s, okay? He also understood the type of people that would have soirees or private parties in their homes, and they would invite a conjurer to come and entertain them. Think Robert Houdin, think Hofzinser in the 1900s, think Charles Bertram, for example. In the 1930s, we come into the nightclub era. But this era is specifically the parlor presentations. If you've ever seen the film The Illusionist, Edward Asenheim, that will give you a sensation of what it must have been like during that period to see a great magician perform and entertain. And this book addresses the context in which card magic can be published. This is a very intelligent book written by a very intelligent man. He specializes in communications. That's his day job. And here he applies a great analytical mindset to this particular studies, because most of his work in Argentina is stand-up for large audiences, and card magic features very much. I had the pleasure of seeing him perform close-up upstairs in a bar in Buenos Aires the morning that I landed. I was tired, but his performance woke me up. He did classical close-up magic. Beautiful. He performs regularly at a venue called Bar Magico in Buenos Aires. This is where I saw the wonderful Pablo Zanata perform his show. One of my favorite magicians on planet Earth. Roberto, one of my favorite magicians ever. Why? Because he presents magic with class, he presents it with style, with dignity, and he treats his audience with dignity and respect. That's the kind of magician I've always aspired to be. And here's someone who embodies all of the belief systems that I hold dear. So let's talk about this book, Stand Up Card Magic. Right. Publication, Vanishing Ink. It was originally published in Spanish. So we have to thank Rafael Benatar and Peter Kopp for their efforts in translating this book. And as I look through it, we have over 150 pages of incredible magic. The book starts off with Roberto's thoughts on parlor card magic. Let me just go to this section, because I was reading it earlier and there was something that jumped out that I wanted to share with you. He gives us a definition, and I'll quote it verbatim. I would like to present the features I regard as essential, primary, and secondary for parlor card magic. Parlor card magic is a brand of magic that revolves around a deck of cards that is performed in a parlor, a living room, under the working conditions that such circumstances imply. Okay, this means standing, no table, not sitting down. There may be a table present, but the performer is standing throughout the entire presentation. Stop and think for a minute. Imagine you get a telephone call and you're invited to come and entertain 30 people, and you've been specifically asked to perform 40 minutes of stand-up card magic. Would you accept that booking? Nothing else, just a deck of cards and your ability to weave a compelling narrative. Can you do it? Roberto stresses that the performance is offered to everyone simultaneously. This is qualitatively different than walking around at a cocktail reception, approaching people, disturbing their conversation to say, pick a card, any card. It's qualitatively different than approaching a table in a restaurant where you've got three or four people who have come out specifically to enjoy an evening meal in a classy environment. This is a very alien environment to be presenting magic. But if you've been invited to a soiree or a private party and you've been specifically asked to bring your show, now, this is where we can create an extraordinary experience for people. This book addresses this, and it will teach you how to do it, okay? The opening effect is magnificent. I'm going to describe the effect. A playing card is generated by several members of the audience. Roberto has the deck shuffled by several members of the audience. The deck is assembled. A random number is generated. The deck that was just shuffled is now counted to that number, and at that number is the randomly generated playing card. This routine is called Eureka. And if you know anything about science, Eureka is the famous phrase once uttered by, was it Archimedes? In the bathtub, he sits in and the water overflows, and he understood the secret to flotation and water displacement. Eureka, I found it. This book teaches you one of the best versions of any card at any number. I loved it so much, I developed my own procedure based on Roberto's exact concept, which I put in my show. It's a blockbuster, okay? One of my favorite routines in this book, I first learnt in the Royal Road to Card Magic. the routine is called Everybody's Card. This routine goes back to the days of Robert Houdin. In the classic book, The Secrets of Conjuring and Magic, Robert Houdin describes one of the greatest mysteries ever, where one card transforms into four previously selected playing cards and then changes back again. It's based on a magnificent principle. It's a combination of psychology, sleight of hand, management, audience management, setting, context. It's a routine I only ever perform in parlor situations. I don't perform this specific routine anywhere else. Why? Excuse me. Because of how the method works. And Roberto describes his exact handling. He also goes on to describe a wonderful variation on a routine that was first published by Percy Diaconis in Di Vernon's Di Vernon's Ultimate Card Secrets by Lewis Ganson, the fourth volume in the Inner Secret series. This is where Percy Diaconis released his Les Cartes Diaconis. Okay, and I think Roberto calls his handling, let's have a look. Yes, he calls it Thanks to Diaconis. In fact, this section of the book addresses the general card, his handling for Everybody's Card, and his version of the Diaconis routine. And it's absolutely beautiful. What we find here are ways to elevate the visual nature of card magic. Have you ever considered doing Out of This World for a large audience? This is a flat routine that's done on the surface of the table. The original Out of This World. Roberto's found a way to elevate it so that the whole audience can appreciate the final outcome of reds and blacks being separated. It's all in here. He also goes on to share one of the most poetic expressions in his repertoire. He calls it the different forms of Icarus. This leads us into his handling and narrative for the sign card to envelope. He took an idea of Roberto Jobbi's and created a beautiful narrative for this wonderful effect. If you've ever performed the card in envelope, you know how it's a strong effect. What it has always missed is the big why. Why is this happening? What's the story? What's the narrative? Why should the audience care? One of the things I love about this book, Roberto works hard at communicating the why and the how these routines are cared by the audience he performs for. You have to read it to study it, to find out. One of the beautiful things in this book is his thinking on Carl Germain's wine glass principle. You know the effect, you can actually see a picture of it on the cover of a card transforming in a wine glass when covered briefly with a handkerchief. Well, you've got a whole chapter to explore the many different ways that you can actualize this beautiful effect for people. So, let me share with you what I got from this book for my own work. I started life primarily as a close-up magician. In fact, I struggled for many years to make the transition from close-up to stage. I did the work because my mentor forced me to. I can walk out on a stage and I can entertain, but I wouldn't say that I am a natural stage performer. No, I am a natural close-up and parlor magician. It's in my blood. Why do I say that? Because I learned every routine in the Royal Road to Card Magic. If you've got a copy of The Royal Road, go to your library and open it to the very last chapter. It begins with the Conus Aces. It then goes into Everywhere and Nowhere, The Lady's Looking Glass, Everybody's Cards, Cards Up the Sleeve, Cards Across, Egyptian Pocket. All stand-up card magic. Don't let anyone ever say to you that The Royal Road to Card Magic is not a good book on magic. I will argue with them with every fiber in my being. Why? Because that last chapter gave me a parlor show. My 1 hour show is 80% stand-up card magic, which I flesh out with a few other things. Symphony of the Ring, Slidini Silks, and a few other things. And most of the routines I first learnt from the Royal Road to Card Magic. So when I got Roberto's book, it reminded me of the joy that I felt when I decided to learn and master all the routines in the Royal Road to Card Magic. You could almost consider this book an addendum to the Royal Road to Card Magic, albeit a very sophisticated upgrade to the depth and quality of thinking, study and application of magic to this specific context. So I have to say, this book comes with my highest recommendation. If you're serious about expanding yourself as a performer, a magician, an artist, set yourself the challenge and put together a 15-minute stand-up show. Try 15 to begin with. Don't hurt yourself. 15 minutes. Put together 3 or 4 good tricks that you can tell good stories and present it for an audience of up to 50 people. Film it, watch it, refine it, improve it, repeat it. Watch what happens. Those 15 minutes will become 20 minutes and you'll be inspired to expand things, add things, refine little details here and there. You'll become a storyteller, a raconteur. This is how I operate. I'm a talker, if you can't guess by now. And this book has pride of place in my library. It's a beautiful, magnificent expression of magic from one of the finest magicians on the planet. If you don't know the name Roberto Mansilla, check him out on Instagram. He's got a load of videos there. And you will see exactly what I'm talking about. You might even see a few videos of him performing for lay people on YouTube. Okay, make sure you've got the name right. Mansilla, M-A-N-S-I-L-A. That's a double A, Silla, Roberto Mansilla. And the book is called Naypes. Okay, highly recommended. So my friends, this video has clocked 17 minutes. And I want to thank you again for tuning in. Leave your feedback, because I read every comment, because your comments reveal to me exactly what you're looking for, and I will do my utmost to ensure that all of your needs are met, all of your inquiries get answered, your questions are dealt with. If there's any books out there that you would like my feedback on, then I'll be happy to do the research and give you my opinion. Next month, in the March, I have another fantastic book to share with you. But for now, if you don't have this book, then it's going to be worth every penny. And it will enrich your life. It will enrich your appreciation for magic as a craft. And I honestly believe, not just the routines, but I believe it will do wonders for your self-expression and expansion as a human being when performing for a large group of people. Okay, so listen, thanks very much for tuning in. Let's give Roberto a round of applause. Thank you.